sleeping.
Nine ladies dancing.
Eight maids a-milking.
Seven swans a-swimming.
Six geese a-laying.
Five golden rings.
Five golden rings.
Four calling birds.
Three friends.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, please take your seats. The wedding will begin in 5 minutes. Places, please, everyone. Places. Ladies and gentlemen, the wedding will begin in 10 minutes. Thank you.
There you are. You're supposed to be getting ready.
I am ready. I'm just waiting.
It kind of looks like you're playing games on your phone.
I'm saving the universe. It's something you wouldn't understand.
Well,
may the force be with you.
See?
And also with you.
They get it. It's a squad war.
We are not doing a Star Wars wedding.
Well, this is now Star Trek. Doctor Who? Look, I thought we said non-traditional.
I didn't mean that non-traditional.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? But salt. What light through yonder window breaks? What? I thought we were starting.
Well, look, Jay just got here. I suppose you want to have some sort of Shakespeare tie-dye wedding? She doesn't know how to do that.
Yes.
Well, I could put together a square dance if you still need a theme.
No!
Like when Buffy and Spike are planning their wedding under Willow's spell, or when Anya and Xander are getting married. Of course, neither of those weddings actually happen.
Excuse me, David. I have a flight to D.C. in the morning. Do you think this will be finished by then, or even, I don't know, started?
I don't know.
Well,
what do we do now? That's a good idea.
But first, I'm not wearing this.
What about Christmas? Okay, come on, let's go.
Okay, I know what we should do. We should do Twelfth Night. Because this is Twelfth Night. Your Twelfth Night by William Shakespeare. Ah, yeah, we should do Twelfth Night. Okay, I need some help. Susan, Judy.
Oh, here.
Elena.
Hey. Maybe we can use these props.
I found them in Jenna's car.
And I always carry extra hats with me.
Oh.
And I've always got my camping equipment.
Oh, great. So.
Yeah, let's take a look.
It starts with a shipwreck.
Oh!
Aboard are two twins, a brother and a sister.
Wait, who's going to play the brother?
You know, in Shakespeare time, all the roles were played by men, so I think we can handle it today with all women. Sebastian! My twin brother! Where are you? Viola, my dear twin sister! Where are you?
So, being shipwrecked in a strange town, Viola did what any sensible girl would do. She disguised herself as a boy.
What country friend is this?
This is Illyria, lady. Here, take this hat. Wow, you totally look like a boy.
Who governs here?
Orsino, a noble duke. And a bachelor.
Ooh, I'll serve him.
So, Viola, disguised as a page Cesario, goes to serve the Duke Orsino, who is in love with a wealthy and beautiful lady, Olivia. But Olivia, who is in mourning for her brother, will admit no suitors.
These minds are hell.
If music be the food of love, lay on! Oh, when my eyes did see Olivia first, that instant was I turned into a harp!
Wait. What does this have to do with a wedding?
loves Jenna.
How may I serve you, Duke Orsina?
Take this and unfold the passion of my love. Give her this letter.
No! Good madam. May I see your face?
Is it not done well?
It's excellently done, if that's it all. My lord and master loves you.
How does he love me?
With adorations, with fertile tears, with groans that thunder love, with sighs of fire.
Your lord does know my might well. I cannot love him. Get thee to your lord. I cannot love him. Let him send no more. But perchance if you would like to come and return and tell me what he said? Take this ring.
The Countess Olivia returns this ring to you.
Oh, none of it.
Receive it.
Oh, none of it.
Receive it.
Oh, none of it.
Receive it.
Oh, none of it. Oh, none of it. Oh, none of it. Oh, none of it. Oh, none of it. Oh, none of it.
I left no ring with her. What means this lady? Fortune forbid my outside have not charmed her. Oh, time! Thou must untangle this knot, I. It is too big a knot for me to untie. So now, Orsino loves Olivia. Olivia loves Viola, who she thinks is Cesario, and Viola loves Orsino. You see how that works?
So, remember Viola's twin brother, Sebastian? Well, he's back in town. And it turns out when Viola dresses like a boy, she looks exactly like him. So, when Olivia sees Sebastian, she thinks that he's Cesario, Viola, and wants to marry him.
Blame not this case to find if thou meest well.
I'll go with you, and knowing truth, ever will be truth.
Now, Sebastian has never met her before, but he decides to marry her. Yeah, this part of the story doesn't really make sense. They're telling me to wrap it up, so just go with it.
One face, one voice, one habit, and two persons!
Oh, how wonderful.
I never had a brother, but I had
a sister.
I am Viola!
I shall share in this most happy wreck. Boy, thou hast told me a thousand times thou never shouldst love a woman like to me. Give me thy hand.
So everyone gets married. The end.
Okay. Hurry up, keep going. Okay. Places, please.
I thought we agreed it was Christmas themed.
I thought we agreed it was cat themed. Hold on. I'll go change.
But I gotta... Well, we need to get some Christmas up in here. Merry Christmas, everyone. Welcome to the middle of spring. Jim, why don't you come on up here and help me out with a song to bring some Christmas cheer. Do you? All right. Let me grab something from back here. Because, I know, yeah, everybody. I'm just grabbing a pick, that's all. Wow. That's a lot. Okay, so everybody in the house probably knows that I have a little bit of a cold, so you're going to have to help me out with Jim's favorite Christmas song, Good King Wenceslas. Everybody know that one?
Oh, yeah.
I would think. I got to turn it on. Where are we at here? There we go. All right, ready?
I'm ready.
All right, you can sing along. We're going to let him be the king. All right. Good King Wenceslas looked out on the feast of Stephen, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel. When a poor man came in sight, gathering winter fuel.
Hither, peace, and stand by me.
Thank you.
If thou knowest it, tell them yonder message, who is he? Where and what his plowing?
Sire, he lives a goodly Kent underneath the mountain, right against the forest bend, by St. Agnes Fountain.
Bring me flesh and bring me wine, bring me my logs hither. Thou and I shall see him dine, with me and thither.
Page and monarch, forth they went together. Through the mood went wild lament, and the bitter weather. Silent night is darker now, and the wind blows stronger. My heart, I know not how, I can go no longer.
Mark my footsteps, my good page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter rain, freeze thy blood less coldly.
In his master's steps he trod, where the snow lay winter. He was in the very spot which the saint had printed. Therefore Christian can ensure wealth or egg possessing. He who now will bless the poor shall yourselves find blessing. Well, it wouldn't be a wedding without some interesting bit. But my gosh, this Christmas sweater is not quite right for a Christmas wedding, don't you think?
Not quite.
No. No, it's more like a crazy Christmas sweater party kind of sweater, or like white elephant gift exchange type of thing. Yeah, no. I better go change.
Yeah. Go change.
Where did he go? He's changing again?
Yeah.
But I put on my, Well, what do we do now?
Sing a song.
We got a song.
I can't sing.
Sing.
Oh, I got a character.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
Maybe I should go check on David.
Man, this floor is so awesome, I gotta do some yoga. Hey. I leave you out, didn't you, Allison and Natalia? Huh?
Should we say something?
I don't know.
All right, so down dog anyway? Yeah.
Well, it is his wedding.
Oh, first chaturanga. Oh.
But he looks like a schlemiel.
I don't know, more like a schmazel. It's his wedding. David, maybe, I don't know, is that the best outfit you could have come up with?
Well, it's what I had in my car. I mean, what do you expect? Well, what do you...
Schlemiel Schlemazel, you need to change your clothes.
I probably should.
I like yoga.
You do?
I'm fine with the yoga wedding.
Yeah, we got some instructors here. We could...
Do you want to do yoga, Marilyn?
Some of us don't want to do yoga.
That's not the kind of physical therapy I've been getting.
We're old, David, and we just might end up back in the hospital. Mm.
I could help you with some yoga.
Yeah, we could do some chair yoga.
Well, David, Jenna told me where to send you, you know, like Dickens.
Yeah, we got some people in outfits, too, that haven't put them on.
Wear costumes?
Yeah. All right. And I think I got this one, so we'll be all right. Yeah, Grandma got run over by a reindeer. We are not doing that. I don't even know it. We said improv, but not that improv-y. All right. So we'll do one that, and I think I got it. All right. Yeah, this is one I've been working on, so what the heck. Might as well go for it. It's pretty much a good 12th night song. I think it started in 12th night, actually. Here we come a-wassailing. So. Here we come a-wassailing among the leaves so green. Here we come a-wandering so fair to be seen. Love and joy come to you, and to you your wassail too. And God bless you and send you a happy new year. And God send you a happy new year. God bless the master of this house, likewise the mistress too. And all the little children that round the table go. Love and joy come to you, and to you your wassail too. And God bless you and send you a happy new year. And God send you a happy new year. Thank you. All right, well obviously this is way too casual for a wedding. You think? Oh, come on. I'm more comfortable in this. Okay. I do look cold.
I do always have emergency extra clothes in my purse. So where did he go?
Change?
Yeah. He's changing again? Maybe you should go help him decide what to wear, Tracy. Thank you. Yeah. I think we should just improvise until he gets back. Literally.
Yeah,
you can do Judy.
Yeah,
Heather. I kind of want to play, so Susan, can you come help us? Why don't we play Switch Right, Switch Left?
Okay, switch right and switch left. They are going to be in pairs to improvise, and when I'll say switch right, then their pair will move to the right, and they'll move over and it'll be a new pair, and they have a new scene to improvise, but we're going to give them each a subject. So I'm going to ask for a little help from you. So the first subject for these two is an unusual place for a wedding. Who has an unusual place for a wedding?
Bathroom.
Good job. All right, so switch right. All right, Heather and Judy. Two people you would find at a wedding, and not a bride and groom. We need something more unusual than that and fun. Waiters. Two waiters at a wedding. That's good. Okay, switch right. Okay. All right, so number three, keep it PG. Something a married couple would do together.
No, we won't.
Yoga, fighting during yoga. Okay.
Nice.
All right, switch right. And the last one, a gift for a wedding.
Chocolate fountain.
A chocolate fountain.
Okay. Chocolate fountain. Love that.
Okay. Switch right.
That's your line, huh?
Yeah. All right,
well,
so I will say switch right or switch left when we want the next pair to do a scene. Okay, so go ahead.
Hold on, honey, I'm almost ready. Okay, let me just wash my hands. I don't know if everybody's gonna fit in here.
Well, I mean, we don't have that many friends. I think it'll be fine.
Well, like 90 people showed up. They're out there.
Oh.
Well. Maybe we could set up a camera and just live stream the wedding on Facebook. Okay, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
It's just that leaky pipe up there could be a problem.
Well, you know that thing about throwing rice on people at a wedding? So it'll just be water instead.
I'll see if anybody has rice.
Okay.
Did anybody bring any rice?
No rice?
No.
Okay. Hold on, I gotta pee again.
Switch right.
Sorry.
Hello.
Hello there.
So, is this your first wedding?
No. I've been doing this for over 20 years.
Oh, okay. I was just wondering because you wore the wrong thing and you spilled a drink on the mother of the bride.
Well, just because I'm a little nervous, I don't see what that has to do with anything, and I'm wearing the same thing as you, just in a different color.
But the memo clearly said that all servers were to wear blue.
Well, I just do so many of these, I must have gotten it mixed up with the wedding I did yesterday. And now, honey, let me show you how to hold that tray. You're not quite doing it right. Well, there's just no fixing it. I suppose it will have to do.
Well, how many trays can you hold?
Oh, do you really want to play that game?
I can hold two trays.
One. Two.
That's embarrassing.
That's cheating.
Three. Switch right.
Okay. Listen. Oh. You know, I really hate yoga. Why do you make me do this?
Come on. They say it's relaxing.
I am relaxed.
Come on, dear.
All right, fine. I'm just doing this because I said I would do it. I'm fine. I like it. I like yoga.
But you've got to lift this leg up here. Yeah, there you go. There you go.
Honey, what are you doing?
Well, come on, get up.
Sorry, too much wassail. The sugar.
I told you to lay off the wassail.
Listen.
Now how are we going to do yoga?
You said I can drink all the wassail I want as long as I do yoga to burn off the calories.
But, you know, not when it's like a wassail hangover.
Honey, I told you 1,000 times I'm here, I'm doing yoga.
Switch right.
All right, we need to find them the perfect gift. Well, what is that?
A chocolate fountain.
Oh! Should we get that for the wedding gift?
I don't know. Do you think it's okay? I was just kind of rinsing my hands off and I was kind of thirsty.
Well, it smells good.
Do you think it still looks okay?
It's still going.
things. It just seems to keep more and more chocolate.
Yeah, I know.
Do you
know,
think we could get it wrapped up?
I don't know. Maybe if we got one of those like big reams of wrapping paper.
Switch right.
Okay, just let me wash my hands again.
The pipe is dripping more.
Oh, do you think it has something to do with when I flush the toilet? Here, let's try it again. Whoa!
Green, switch left.
Yeah, here, try this. Let's just put this around it, and maybe we'll wrap it up and it'll be the perfect wedding gift, right?
Green, switch left.
Okay, honey. I'm on board for this yoga thing. I'm doing it because I love you.
You look great, honey. Just keep it up. Okay, now, right knee up. Tree pose. No, not like that. What are you doing?
I saw the
now
dog do it.
Now you're making me choke.
Come on, let me show you. Come on, dear. No, no, not like that. What are you doing?
Freeze. Switch left.
Other left.
Now, as I said, I know I can hold more trays than you. Let me just get another one. All right, and that's three.
Oh, that is
impressive.
Like
to see you top that, my dear.
Oh, there's that really hot chick over there who tips a lot. I will...
Oh, where? Oh! You did that on purpose.
I'm gonna hold that, and...
Now, where's the hot chick? let me get some paper towels.
Okay. No, the water's coming from down. The water's up there. Okay.
Switch left.
I don't know. Something's wrong with the fountain. I don't think this wrapping paper's gonna work now. It's just shooting up into the sky.
Switch right.
Yeah. Okay. Got it.
Wait, there's water there.
Here. Okay. Maybe.
Now, come on, point her out again. I missed where she went.
Can't you see her right over there? You should go check it out.
Why, yes, she is rather hot, isn't she? She's wearing cat ears. How coy.
It is amazing.
Yes.
Well, anyway, since I've got this one tray and you're so good at holding trays, could you maybe like hold this one for me too? On your head? Switch left.
Okay, I don't know if that's going to work. You're just going to have to pee again if you keep drinking all that water.
I know.
It's warm. Here, let's use my jacket my shoe. Here, try that. Let's put something over it. Do you have any chewing gum? Yeah.
Okay.
Try putting that over the leak.
Okay. Freeze.
Well, I guess we agreed the theme is murder mystery since we're both wearing murder mystery costumes.
Yes. But where did you get those clothes?
She didn't say she had some in her purse.
You had this in your purse? Of course you did.
Well, where did your Scarlet Cheek costume come from?
Well, I always keep it around in case we get to do villainous venture again.
So, does this mean we improv a murder mystery?
That would mean that someone would have to die at our wedding?
Well...
No death.
Let's go change.
All right. Come on up, Mark.
All right. Apparently this wedding is never going to get off the ground, so I might as well get up and sing a song. For those of you who know me, my name is Mark Reuter. I'm a professional actor, musical theater.
For those of you who don't know me, my name is still Mark Reuter, and I'm still a professional musical theater actor. Now, a lot of my friends say musical theater is stupid because people don't randomly get up and sing songs. And I'm going, have you met me? So I'm going to sing a song for Christmas, and it's appropriately entitled The Christmas Song. Sung by a choir, and folks dressed up like Eskimos. Everybody knows a turkey and some mistletoe helps to make the season bright. Tiny tots with their eyes all aglow, we'll find it hard to sleep tonight. They know that Santa's on his way. He's loaded lots of toys and goodies on his sleigh, and every mother's child is gonna spy reindeer really know how to fly. And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, Merry Christmas to you.
Dance break, come on. Get up and dance. Yes, come on. Yes. There we go. Let's give it up for my lovely dancers. How about that? Thank you so much, ladies. I appreciate it.
And so I'm offering this simple phrase to kids from 1 to 92. Although it's been said many times, many ways, thank you. Thank you so much.
All right, everyone. The wedding will begin, I think. Where'd they go now?
And finally, the Christmas King.
And his bride. So that the photographer doesn't skin us all. I mean, and now, for a fair song for my bride on this, our wedding day. Okay. This is where we get all schmaltzy.
Aww. Hmm.
he says. All right.
I'm gonna hold your hedgehog.
You were gonna hold my hedgehog? And hopefully this will work. Probably not. There. Was a wealthy merchant, London he did dwell. He had a beautiful daughter, truth he will tell. Oh, the truth he will tell. She had three hearts of plenty, and then a high degree. None Jack the sailor, a true love there could be. Oh, a true love there could be. Jackie's gonna sail in with trouble on his mind. He's left his native country and his darling girl behind. Oh, his darling girl behind. She went down to the tailor shop. She dressed in man's array. She climbed on board a vessel to convey herself away. Oh, convey herself away. Before you get on board, sir, your name we'd like to know. She smiled all in her countenance. Call me Jackero. Oh, just call me Jackero. I see your waist is slender, your fingers they are small. Your cheeks too red and rosy, to face the cannonball. Oh, to face the cannonball. Well, I know my waist is slender, my fingers they are small. But it would not make me tremble to see 10,000 fall. Oh, see 10,000 fall. The war soon being over, she went and looked around. Among the dead and wounded, a darling boy she found. Oh, a darling boy she found. She picked him up into her arms and carried him to the town. She sent for a physician who quickly healed his wounds. Oh, he healed his wounds. Well, this couple, they got married, so his wife picked a song. This couple, they got married, so why not you and me? Oh, now why not you and me? Oh, why not you and me?
Well, that was lovely. Well, maybe a little formal.
Yeah, it was a little formal. What about Kiggy's?
Well, I thought we were going with the Christmas theme.
Yeah, we are. But they still don't understand what Kiggy's are.
Why don't we speak in Kiggy talk?
Oh, I forgot. Yay.
Yeah, some people are really wanting to know about
that. That's right. Well, I'll just talk in Kiggy talk then.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, hi, I'm a Kiggy. Okay, go away now. Go away quickly.
What's this, Kiggy? You go don't away. Like them?
No, Kiggy, no.
But you're a good one.
Oh. And they still look confused.
I don't think they understand.
Especially Anne. She's like, huh?
I'm not sure anybody understands what we're saying. Remember, we wanted all of our guests to feel loved and included at this wedding.
Well, she can have my bells.
Well, you only have one set of bells, though.
I know, they just fell off.
Isn't there some way they could all be Kiggies on this special day?
I know of one way. The Kiggy song!
Yes, the Kiggy song! And look, everybody has cat ears. Oh!
Yes, put your cat ears on.
Yeah.
All right.
So if you don't have your cat ears on...
All right, here we go. I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? It's a Kiggy song, you can join right in. You can sing it with your friends. I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? It's a Kiggy song, you can join right in. You can sing it with your friends. And I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, you're not Kiggy, you're gonna be a Kiggy too. It's a Kiggy song, you can join right in. You can sing it with your friends. I'm a Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? Kiggy, you're a Kiggy, wouldn't you like to be a Kiggy too? Kiggy song, you can join right in. And we could go on forever and ever, because that's all I wrote.
Now, why don't you tell them where Kiggy Talk came from?
Well, yes, that's why you all came here. And apparently, yeah. Some of you are like, yeah, that's really it. And if some of you have looked online at definitions, I would advise you not to do that. That it has nothing to do with it. I didn't realize that until it was called to my attention by the pastor, by the way. but no. So more in the middle, so the photographer doesn't like skin us alive. Well, okay, so Kiggy is literally, like in your program, it does mean kitty. And for about 10 years or so, I was living alone in Belmont, and I would spend a lot of time with my four cats, and I would speak out of the side of my mouth like this, and over here, make different voices, because I love voices, and you guys know that, or many of you do. So I just, because I was just talking out of the side of my mouth, and... You know, 10 years ago, I never would have been able to share this kind of thing, you know. And I met her. So it's a Kiggy wedding. So that's what it means. And, you know, sharing music and playing it with all of you is you know, performing is what I love most about her. So.
And what I would like to share with you is a sonnet. So I did some research, and I found a Shakespearean sonnet that is perfect for this occasion. In fact, it strangely almost seems like it was written for you.
Oh. Well, I did know Willie.
Sonnet number 1619. Oh, love, both joy and sorrow can it bring. In sugar magnolia, happiness thou find. Of pain and heartbreak, others still do sing. And love doth suffer long, but yet is kind. With this my verse, may you, my love, feel loved. If love by words thus written may be shown. If love by deeds and gifts and touch be proved. Let me give so that you shall not feel alone. Time was I wished for someone who might see and value what is kind in me. Feel I such joy that now I can a Kiggy be. And grateful so that you to me be nigh. And so, as years do pass and we do grow, I wish that you, my love, shall ever know.
Aww. Mm. All right. Cue the ring bearer.
What is Frodo here?
No, not that ring bearer.
Is that what Level's costume is?
Oh. He's coming.
That ring bearer.
Aww.
Oh, a nephew ring bearer. I see.
He hasn't stolen the show yet. It's amazing.
Oh, he will.
For those who haven't met Wesley, he's going to eat them. Please don't allow that to happen.
All right. Audience, line one. Are you ready to bind yourselves together with these rings?
What, the one ring to rule them all?
No, there are two rings, remember?
Three rings for the Elven Kings under the sky. Two rings for Kiggies who like pie.
Well, that's totally true, but that's not in the official original Elvish lore on the rings, I mean.
Audience, line two. David and Jenna, do you pledge to never give up childish ways and only be an adult when you absolutely have to?
I do.
Audience, line three. Do you promise to take care of each other and have fun whenever possible?
I do.
Wait, who's actually marrying you?
Well, you all are, just like on Big Bang Theory. Trademark.
I'm not sure that's going to work. David, you did remember to bring the marriage license, right?
Yeah, they're in the bathroom. No, it's backstage.
I've got that covered.
Oh. Woo! Oh. Yeah, thank goodness.
Marriage. Marriage is what brings us together today. Marriage, that blessed arrangement, that dream within a dream, and love. And love, true love, will follow you forever and ever. I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Now we're going to take some pictures and eat some food. The first picture is going to be of all of you, though.
Yes.
So don't move.
Just stay put a sec. Okay. Oh, we did. Oh, we have to kiss.
The what?
Non-traditional.
Let me ask her.
Wait, no, every time they do that, we have to kiss.
Oh.
Do you want the ladder?
The ladder? Oh.
So you do need the ladder.
We're going to have a ladder. We're going to marry the ladder next.
We wanted to get a picture of everybody. So, that's right.
We have to get a serious ladder. My lamp.
We're going to have our photographer.
Well, it is an unusual wedding.
Safely stand on this very sturdy ladder and get a picture of everybody.
60 years old, folks. Jeez, you can't. And my computer loves to be part of that. Now, does anybody have any, like, roof work they need done? Or?
And then all of us need to, like, kind of mix in.
Oh,
so
we have to mix
in? Literally everybody.
Okay.
Who's here?
Thank you.
We like you. We really like you. Keep asking us again and again. We like you. We have got a very good reason. Since we've been with you, cats and smiles have been in season. Mr. Rogers said it best by far. Like you just the way you are. Still will yell to the sky till you understand why that we like you.
I'm just glad I wasn't the one that spilled something. Okay. So now I need my husband to come up here and join me because I have a little speech for the bride and groom. Oh, after we're done mopping up water. To walk amongst yourselves. I'll give you a topic. No, Saturday Night Live, anyone? No, okay.
This is why we can't have nice things.
It's okay, it's just water.
It's fine.
Okay, are you ready? So my speech is a little musical, and I'm going to need your help singing the chorus. But before we do that, can everybody in the back hear the guitar okay? Yes? Okay, great. So the chorus is really simple. It goes like this. Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. Not too hard, right? Okay, now you try. Here we go. Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. Good. So, every time I say everybody, that's when you start singing. Pretty simple, right? Okay. Here we go. Everybody. Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. My sister Jenna got married today. Times are changing, I'm a mother. David is her husband now, Wesley's uncle and my brother. David and Jenna tied the knot on this 12th night, or close enough, with Shakespeare Christmas, murder mysteries, cats, and other stuff. Everybody! Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. If our mom was here to see you wed in her wedding cloth, she'd have bought you tons of Christmas stuff, all at 75% off. She'd have been so proud of you and your new alliance. And she would have told you that marriage, well, it's not rocket science. Everybody! Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. So David and Jenna, I give all my love to you and all your cats. Marriage means that you'll have to wear all kinds of different hats. But if you're half as happy as Joshua and I, it won't matter that your wedding is dry. You'll each have quirks, but you won't mind. Because like us, I think you'll find that life is better when you're together. Aw, barf, I know. But it's true, and so everybody! Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding. One more time! Ding dong, fa la la, ding dong, fa la la, Kiggy wedding day. Happy wedding, we love you.
I wrote all this down so I wouldn't forget it, but maybe once you hear it, you'll wish I hadn't written it down. If your mom had been here today, Jenna,
she would have been rewritten the script twice and insisted the decorations were not right. We all miss her, but her presence is ever in our lives. A father never thinks anyone is good enough for his daughter. So, David, you're no exception. Sorry. But Jenna is very happy with you, and that's what's important. Jenna and David, you really have spiced up this dance hall and made it into a very wonderful and festive party. I'm amazed at the transformation. It's nothing like when we dance here. I wish you a very happy Kiggy wedding day and a wonderful Kiggy journey through life.
From some of the pieces that people had to rehearse and work on, and putting up all the decorations and food, and so.
And Elena with her injured knee, which I hope she's, she did all of the, you know, the tables and stuff with the creative, you know, drawing on them. And I have so many people from out of state, and Amy from out of state, and I've got hopefully several people watching online from everywhere from Japan and Greece and everywhere, so, wow, thank you all.
And you guys for coming and having fun with us. And
yeah.
We started planning this and it just kind of grew and had to be all these things, and thank you for
indulging us.
Yes, exactly.
Just slice.
You got the sharp end up.
Oh, good. That works.
The one that you have, David, is supposed to, like, scoop it.
I know.
Okay.
I'm just being stupid.
You just, okay. I'm just making sure.
Right. Okay. So,
do you want to...
You gotta shove a piece in the face.
Oh, I know.
Yeah, there's plates right there. Yeah. You can
work on the cookie put. And we'll just have people. Do you want to take a
picture of me cutting the cookie? No, you guys are supposed to do like a piece of cake to be like.
We're not gonna. No, we don't want to mess up their.
Let me ask somebody to help us, and we'll like.
That's what I'm telling them, and they're not listening.
I know. We don't do tradition.
I sing out of my nose.